हेलो गाइस, स्टैंडर्ड 6 चैप्टर नंबर 16 एयर अराउंड अस। सो गाइस, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो एस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कि हाउ एयर इज अवेलेबल इन सोइल, देन हाउ द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन वाटर कैन सर्वाइव, हाउ दे कैन ब्रीद, हाउ दे कैन एब्सॉर्ब ऑक्सीजन प्रेजेंट इन वाटर, that we have discussed. Now today what are we going to learn? Today we will learn about the carbon footprint, how to take care of air, right? So actually what happens, as we know that due to the uses of coal, petrol, diesel, kerosene, wood, other fossil fuels, oil, it put more carbon dioxide in air. And what happens if there is more carbon dioxide present in air? It absorbs more and more sunlight, right? So average temperature of Earth's surface increases. So what happens? There will be weather change. So due to the weather change, the ice which is present in northern plateau will start to melt, and the level of water which is in air, which is in ocean, it increases, and there will be problem of tsunami, right? So this process, this increasing carbon dioxide in air, and the reason and the other side effect is called as global warming, right? And second thing is that due to the cut of tree, plants in the entire world, it is also responsible for the increasing of carbon dioxide. Why? If there is less number of trees are present, so what happens? The quantity of removing carbon dioxide by plants and forest will be less. So pumping carbon dioxide from the air by the plant and forest will be very less. So it absorbs less carbon dioxide. So automatically quantity of carbon dioxide in the air will increase. If you take out the books of Oxford of Science of 2015 and 16, you can see the percentage of carbon dioxide in air was 0.02%, right? And right now it is 0.04%. Here we can see in the diagram 16.7. So there are so many activities which causes pollution and increases the level of carbon dioxide in air. So there are so many activities. So if we reduce the activity which causes the carbon dioxide and release carbon dioxide in air, and we put in this diagram, if there is too much green zone and green areas are too much and there will be less yellow zone, so this steps of the diagram is called as carbon footprint. And if it is more green zone, that is good for us, right? That is called as the carbon footprint. So government is trying to reduce the carbon footprint and trying to reduce the yellow zones, right? So there are so many things, do not use plastic, right? Then use the material which is recyclable, use 3R's formula, right? There are so many things, then so many activities which do not release carbon dioxide and reduces the level of the carbon dioxide. And if we reduce the uses of the vehicles which runs on petrol, diesel and kerosene and coal, so there will be less pollution in air, right? and we can take care of climate and weather also. So by this the activity, by these steps of the all the activities, we can reduce carbon footprint. Now next topic is how air is useful. So first of all, for the all the living things, air is useful because there is oxygen which is present in air. So for the respiration system and breathing system, air is useful for plants and animals. If air is clean, then it is healthier to us. Second, movement of air creates wind. So due to the wind, what happens? There is wind farm, and in wind farm there is windmill, right? So windmill that generates electricity. So wind energy is called as renewable energy because we can use it again and again due to the speed of wind, and it is not polluting, right? Then if we discuss about the plant and pollination, so there is seed dispersal process, right? And there is pollination process also. So for both the process, air is very much helpful. If we discuss about for transportation, so due to the air, helicopter and aeroplane can move from one place to the another place. It can travel in the air, right? Then about the boat. So we have seen that in boat there is sail. So using sails and wind, boat can run on the surface of water. It can float on the surface of water and takes more speed. Now about the direction. Moving air turn, it shows the direction of wind and volume of the wind, right? By wind soak and wind band. And movement of air. So when air moves, it creates wind current, and air current is called as, which is helpful to bring rainfall, right? Now let's see today's homework. Take out MCQs in exercise, solve MCQ number 8 and 9, then turn your page. Two example 3 and 4 solve in textbook. Now long question answers 3, 4 and 5 write it down in notebook. Okay guys, this was homework. Thank you, have a nice day.